Recently, I got interested in home automation and was looking for something to automate. I decided to add remote control to a pair of my ceiling lamps I installed in my living room way back in year 2004. Now we have year 2015, so it was 11 years ago, and these lamps still operate great without any maintenance. This is one of them. Beautiful. So why not to challenge them to go to the next level and become my first home automation device? Do you think we can do it? Sure thing. This lamp is operated with a single push button like this. One click, light goes off. Another click, lamps go on. Off, on, and so on. Really? But wait. If you hold it, intensity goes down. If you release, it stays unchanged. If you hold it once more, it goes up. Down, up. So with this single push button, you can do four things. You can switch the lamp on, you can switch it off, you can increase intensity, and you can decrease intensity. So pretty nice set of four actions for home automation system. So now let's go into implementation details. How to add remote control to such lamp? It is not difficult. Stick with me and I will show you how. This is how original circuit looks like. There is the power supply, the lamp, and the push button. To provide remote control in parallel to the push button, I will add a relay that will turn the lamp on and on exactly as when using the push button. Relay will be operated by microcontroller that in turn will receive commands over Wi-Fi from a tablet or a smartphone. To set the light intensity to specific level, I have added a line sensor. The light sensor will be read by micro that will adjust the light intensity to required level. I'm not going to write a custom app for a tablet or a phone. Instead, I will use existing open source home automation server that comes ready with apps for mobile devices. All this equipment will communicate over lightweight protocol called MQTT that is well suited for home automation networks. Now let me show you a couple of hardware and software details of my implementation of this concept. The relay and microcontroller comes from Olibex, and the exact model is ASP8266-EVB. The light sensor may be purchased in any online shop with electronics component. I have selected photoresistor LDR07. The home automation server is set up on OpenHub. It can run on a PC, Raspberry Pi, or Android, or on several other platforms. In my particular case, it is running on Synology NAS DS414. The tablet or a smartphone is of your choice. Open hubs apps are available for Apple iOS and Android. To control my labs, I have been using Apple iPad and Android's Samsung Galaxy smartphone. A Google Chrome on a PC will also do the job. To power up your microcontroller and relay board, you will need a small 5V DC power supply. I have purchased mine in local supermarket. Depending on your application, you will also need an enclosure, couple of screws, washers, nuts, spacers, grommets, terminal block, and connectors. Add couple of cables and it will make pretty complete list of building blocks you need. Quite interesting part of this project was development of items, sitemaps and rules for OpenHub, as well as development of firmware for ASP8266 microcontroller. Let me show you some details. To learn OpenHub, I have started with loading and understanding demo setup configuration. Then I have been looking for additional examples on OpenHub Wiki. It is quite versatile platform and it took me some time before I got familiar with it and understood how it works. The point was to check how stable it is and if it contains all the functionality I thought I would need for my home automation projects. The microcontroller firmware was prepared with excellent unofficial development kit for Expressive ASP8266 by Mikhail Grigoriev. It is using Eclipse user interface where you write your code and then with just a couple of clicks compile and flash this code to ASP8266 board. The kit contains in one place everything you need to develop and test your firmware and comes together with several example projects including NICE, ASP underscore MQTT client by 21PM. I have used it as a base and added to it my library to operate the LAMP. If you are interested in details, please check my repository on GitHub. By the way, you will also need a LAMP to play with. I have shown you previously what I'm using. It is called Square and it comes from Italian company Treci Luce. They have a lot of nicely designed LAMPs. I recommend checking their catalog. Beautiful. You need to make two critical decisions when selecting the LAMP. First one is to pick nice LAMP enclosure. Your friends and family may not be interested in home automation. They may not see a point of spending time and money to automate a crusty light bulb. Pick a nice LAMP that fits your style. A simple modern like this square, old style and decorative like this chandelier, or maybe funky and crazy like this neons. Second decision concerns electronics inside the LAMP. It should provide one button switch and dim control. There are various options available depending on light source inside the LAMP. My application is using fluorescent tubes. Here you can see three examples of electronic ballast that provide switch and dim control. First one is by Philips. I found this one to be the most reliable. Second one is by Osram. This one also cuts the mustard. And the third is by Tridonic. This one unfortunately failed after a year or two since installation. I replaced it with Philips that operates without any issues for 10 years already. Here is my square, how it looks from bottom and from top. On the left you can see diffuser that is facing down. Chassis that is facing towards the ceiling is on the right. You can see controller attached on top. The cutout in the chassis is to project some light towards the ceiling. Light sensor is installed on the left of control box. On the right of the box you can see two cables, one to provide mains power and the second to control the LAMP. Let me remove the cover of the control box. Inside control box there is a microcontroller with relay and a power supply providing 5V for the microcontroller. The two cables from right of the control box are going inside the chassis. One connected to the mains power supply and the second one is hooked up in parallel with conventional wall push button. That's it. Now it's time to install both LAMPs and see how they perform live. Are you still with me? Okay, so let me install LAMPs and do some live testing. However, before connecting LAMPs to mains power, I should disconnect circuit breaker to my ceiling lighting. So let's do it. I should be safe now. However, please do not tinker with mains power if you are not qualified to do so. We'll be right back.
Both lamps are now installed and we are ready to do some testing of remote control. Let me start with Apple iOS device, which happens to be iPad. Let me start Open Hub, put both lamps on. Now let me increase light intensity. You can hear clicks of relay, which are simulating push buttons. Now let me decrease light intensity. Everything is working great. And finally, switch both lamps off. For next test, I have selected Android device, which is Samsung Galaxy smartphone. So let's do the same test. Let me put both lamps on and increase light intensity and decrease it. And finally, switch both lamps off. And finally, what about humble wall push buttons? These push buttons are always at your service, sitting always on the same place on the wall. Just in case your mobile device is not handy, or runs out of battery. This concludes my presentation how to remotely operate dim able lamp with one button switch and dim control. If you like it, give it a big thumbs up or leave a comment and give big thumbs up. See you next time.